Hello, my dear students. We are going to solve these three outstanding problems, and all the problems are connected to each other and all are very competent problems. So let's try to integrate them. And I am Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi with you. So I'll begin with the problem number 1. 0 to 1 cot inverse, 0 to 1, so let the integral be is equal to I, 0 to 1 x square cot inverse 1 minus x cube plus x to the power 6, which we can write as x cube whole square dx. And now we shall put t is equal to x cube. And whenever we put or we use some substitution in integral, we use to differentiate that. So on differentiating both the sides, dt by dx with respect to x, it becomes 3x square, and therefore dt upon 3 will be x square dx. So this x square dx, x square and dx can be replaced by dt by 3, but it is a question of definite integral. So we will have to think of limits too. So we will be changing now limits as per the substitution. So when x is 0, because lower limit is 0, when x is 0, t is what? So you can see t is what? T is x cube. So there it becomes t is equal to 0 cube means 0. And when x is? When x is 1, when x is 1, t will be what? T will be 1 cube, and 1 cube is 1. So the integral reduces into I is equal to, the integral will be reduced into, limits will remain same. You can see here, as earlier limits were 0 to 1, now again the limit is 0 to 1. So lower limit is 0, upper limit is 1, no change in limit. And it becomes 1 by 3, because x square dx is what? Dt by 3. So 1 by 3, and dt I will write here, cot inverse 1 minus t plus t square dt. Now you can see the question number 2. Now it has become similar to question number 2. Question number 2 is cot inverse 1 minus x plus x square, and limit is 0 to 1. And here we have 0 to 1, 1 by 3 cot inverse 1 minus t plus t square. Except 1 by 3, everything is same. And you would be thinking about t. So definite integrals are independent of variables. So whether it is t or x, answer will remain same. So you can see that this question, the question number 1, is an outstanding question, which includes second question in it. Cot inverse we can write as tan inverse 1 upon 1 minus t plus t square dt, because cot inverse x is tan inverse 1 upon x. Here I mention the result so that if you are a beginner, you will find comfortable in solving this question. Now, in numerator, some adjustment is needed, and that adjustment is this. First, let's write this denominator, and denominator I can write as 1 minus t, t common from these two, minus t. 1 minus t. So numerator I'll have to write like this, t plus 1 minus t. Now you can see the benefit. What is benefit of writing like this? Dt. In numerator, what I did? Added and subtracted t. So there is no change in numerator at all. Now we have a formula, tan inverse a plus tan inverse b is equal to tan inverse a plus b upon 1 minus ab. So this formula can be used here. So it will be like this, 1 by 3, 0 to 1, and on using this formula, it becomes tan inverse t plus tan inverse 1 minus t dt. Now we can separate both the integrals. So on separating them, we find like this, integral, the first one is 0 to 1, tan inverse t plus dt, of course, 0 to 1, tan inverse 1 minus t dt. This second integral, means second and first both are same integrals, but it does not look like the first one. So there is a property known as King's property, and the King's property says a to b f of x dx is equal to a to b f of a plus b minus x dx. This property I can apply in any of the integrals, in any of the definite integrals, but I'll not apply in the first one because it is already in the simplest form. So I'll apply this property in second integral. So is it possible that in one of the integral we apply and in other we don't? Yes, it is possible, because both the integrals are different integrals. But the problem is that we are writing them together. So we can apply this property in the second integral, and first we shall keep as it is. Or if you have any problem, or if you are thinking about that, about this, that this may be a problem, no need to worry. You may take this first integral as I1 and second as I2. Integrate them separately and then add them to find final result. So if I apply this property here, then what is a? A is 0, b is 1. So it becomes tan inverse bracket 1 minus t must be replaced by a plus b, means 0 plus 1 minus t into dt. So after applying the property, it will be looking like this, 1 by 3, integral 0 to 1, tan inverse t dt plus 0 to 1. Here you can see in the second integral, 1 will be cancelled, minus into minus will be plus, so it is tan inverse dt. That is what I was saying, that though both the integrals are same, but not were looking at that moment, but now you can realize that both are same. So I can double the first one, 2 by 3, integral 0 to 1, tan inverse t dt. Now to integrate this, we shall use integration by parts. So this is 2 by 3, integral 0 to 1, tan inverse t into 1 into dt. Tan inverse t should be considered as first and 1 as second. Using this concept, I let inverse, log, algebraic, trigonometric and exponential. The solution I am writing for all the students, even though they are beginners. And if you are good in integration or in definite integral, you can skip the steps. I stands for inverse, log, L stands for log, A stands for algebraic. So what kind of functions are algebraic? Algebraic are x, x square, 1 upon x, and even constants like 2, 3, 4, k, they are called algebraic. So here 1 is what? 1 is algebraic, and first one is inverse, and T stands for trigonometric. In this concept, or in this, you can say, trick of Hilbert, T stands for trigo, but I is independent. I is inverse trigonometric function, and E for exponential. Exponential are e to the power x, 2 to the power x, like that. E to the power x, 2 to the power x. These kind of functions are called exponential. So now I am quoting the result of this integration by parts. Suppose we have product of two functions. So the rule says first function constant. Integrate the second one minus an integral of differential of first, integral of second, differential of first into integral of second, and then dx. Means after doing the inner part, we shall have to integrate it again. So this rule will be used. We are saying one is what? Tan inverse t. And about limit, about if some limit is there in this, it suppose if we have limit, then we shall use this kind of bracket, and here we shall quote the limit. So it is 2 by 3. You can see bracket tan inverse t integral of 1 d by dt of tan inverse t integral of 1 and dt, because we have here dt in formula, we have used dx, but here we have dt instead of dx. And limit will be 0 to 1. Now it is 2 by 3 bracket tan inverse t integral of 1 is t, differential of tan inverse t is 1 upon 1 plus t square, and integral of 1 is t dt. Of course dt is there, 0 to 1. Now again we have got an integration, this integration. So to integrate this, we can use this concept, multiply and divide by 2, 1 plus t square dt, 0 to 1. T into tan inverse t, and to integrate this, either you can use a formula, or independently you can integrate this f dash x upon fx dx. If numerator is derivative of denominator, then answer of this will be ln mod of f of x plus c. But it is a definite integral, therefore no c, no integral constant must be used. So 2 by 3, or you can integrate it separately and you can put 1 plus t square as u square, 1 plus t square as u, and therefore it will become 2t dt is equal to du, and therefore this part will be like this, du upon u, and integration of du upon u is ln mod of u, ln mod of u. And similarly this formula will work. So both the methods are open, you can use any of them. So t tan inverse t minus 1 by 2, it is ln 1 plus t square mod of 1 plus t square and limit is 0 to 1. Now as you know that first we shall substitute the upper limit. So 2 by 3 outside a bracket. First we shall put t is equal to 1 tan inverse 1 minus 1 by 2 log of 1 plus 1 square bracket close minus. Now we can put 0 tan inverse 0 minus 1 by 2 log of 1. 1 plus 0 is 1, so let it be 1. 2 by 3, tan inverse t is pi by 4 minus 1 by 2 log 2 minus 0 into tan inverse is 0. And log 1 as we know is 0, therefore it is 0. So on multiplying 2 by 3 inside, it becomes pi by 6 minus 1 by 3, pi by 6 minus 1 by 3 log 2. So this is the answer of question number 1. As question number 1 and 2 are same except this 2 by 3. So the answer will be same except this 2 by 3. Means answer of the question number 1 will be this. Sorry, question number 2 will be pi by 4 minus 1 upon 2 log 2. And as far as question number 3 is concerned, tan inverse 0 to 1 2x minus 1 upon 1 minus x plus x square dx. This we can write 0 to 1 tan inverse x plus x minus 1. And this we can write 1 minus x common. Sorry, 1 minus x and this is x minus 1. So it was 1 plus x minus x square, not 1 plus x minus x square. So if I take common minus x, it becomes like this. Again, let's check the question. So 1 plus x minus x square, it is correct. 1 plus x minus x square, 1 plus x minus x square. And if we use the formula which we have already used in integral number 1, tan inverse x plus tan inverse x minus 1, it will be, and if we separate them, then this will be like this. And if you use King's property in this, so it becomes 0 to 1 tan inverse 0 plus 1 minus x minus 1 dx. We have used King's property. There is no authentic name of this, but we used to say that the most, because the property is most important property, we used to say that it is King's property. So 0 to 1, tan inverse, this is minus x, minus can be taken common, so it becomes minus here. So it will be minus tan inverse x, and this is 0 to 1 tan inverse x. And now it is clear to you that answer is 0. So I am with you, Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi. For any kind of confusion, you can write to me. This is my name, Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi, Vice President Awardee for one of my research papers. Many of my research papers are published on various international journals. You can Google, and my WhatsApp number is this. You can approach me if you wish to approach. This is my WhatsApp number, and do write in comment box. Please like and share the channel. My best wishes with you. Wish you all the best.